Hello farmers, welcome back. This is Mr. Vetter Group. Today let's talk about steaming up. So steaming up in dairy cows, it is normally done 2 months to calving down. It is very important to dairy cows, especially those heavy feeders. So this is the process where certain feed rations are introduced and some are reduced. And more so, you normally concentrate on the concentrates and the mineral supplements. So the mineral supplements you normally introduce when it is the cow is 7 months old. You normally use a dry cow, like we have Makilik dry cow from Cooper's company, Tugalik dry cow from Twiga company, and many other companies. So it is very important to the cows. The steaming up, the mineral salts normally prepare the udder. It maintains the health-wise of that calf and born calf, and then it reduces chances of milk fever, and then easy calving down during the parturition time, and then so that the placenta may come out at the right time. So the minerals are very important, and then the concentrates, we normally introduce them, but at a certain ratio where we consider the production of that cow. So it is very important for a dairy farmer to steam up the dairy cow when it is 7 months old or any calf. So if you fail to do so, there are many consequences that will occur, and more so the dairy farmers. So like if you fail to steam up your dairy cow, there are high chances you can of milk fever can occur, and then that cow or the calf that will be born, it will be weak and healthy. And when it is weak and healthy, it will be attacked by many diseases. It will be prone to diseases when it is young. And at a young stage, it can be attacked with any disease. So, and then for the side of the cow, the milk will not be, for example, when it was producing like 14 liters a day, average of 14 liters, you may find it will not maintain that 14 or 15 liters. We may lower down even to 10 liters or 8 liters. That is if you fail to steam up that cow. So the cow also, it may be attacked by milk fever. And you know, milk fever may affect that cow, and may make it not to pick up in the side of milk production. It will not pick quickly. And maybe you may end up losing that cow because of milk fever. And milk fever, you see, that is a mostly calcium deficiency. So you may end up calling a vet, and then you call a vet when it is chronic. So survival becomes 50-50. A vet treats it, and then to survive becomes 50-50. And because the muscles are very much attacked, it may end up laying down, making it to paralyze. So those are much effects of many effects that milk fever may bring it. And then the side of placenta, we may end up by having retained placenta. And you see the effects of retained placenta, it may affect the milk production. Or the farmer will end up calling a vet to treat a cow. And you see that is costly also. As a farmer, we are now losing. We are not gaining. We are losing. And some farmers normally make a mistake. They milk that cow up to some weeks or a week to calving down. That is a very big mistake that our farmers normally do. Unlike our farmers, calf. It was weak, so we normally go boost it with antibiotics and multivitamin, and then we try to introduce pellets so that we can maintain that health of that calf. So that calf, at least a month, I'm cold, it is weak. After a month, I'm cold, it is diarrhea. So farmers should consider a lot the steaming up. Steaming up, you reduce certain ratios. You make sure you stop milking your cow. Make sure you separate that cow to a certain place so that it may stay alone. And then make sure you do some follow-up to that cow. Maybe it may be sick, or it may be being attacked by a certain disease. So you follow up now and then that cow, see how it is doing. So I'll urge the farmers to consider steaming up in their dairy cows. Yeah, that is much you can talk of. Thank you.